I can't.
And welcome to the last session in the weightlifting competition in the 2012 Olympic Games here in London. And welcome once again to the XL Arena. This is the final weight division. It's the gentlemen above 105 kilograms. And it's the climax to the whole tournament in terms of men's weightlifting, and ultimately decides who indeed is the strongest man on the planet. That's just a measure of what exactly these gentlemen have got to lift. We have a very, very competitive super heavyweight division. We've got the world's number one and the world's number two, plus the defending Olympic champion from Germany, Matthias Steiner, who became the Olympic gold medalist for Germany, having competed 4 years earlier for his native Austria in the Athens Olympic Games in 2004. That is the lifting platform. It measures 4 meters by 4 meters. And some of the weights about to be attempted by some of these men are absolutely frightening. We've seen a number of world records go. We've seen a number of Olympic records go. But the important thing here for all these lifters is to secure an Olympic weightlifting medal. Yuri Orshag, the 23-year-old European silver medalist in 2011. And he's got one of the lightest body weights, the second lightest body weight at 128.15 kilograms. And he's coming in for his first attempt in the snatch at 182 kilograms. Hugely important psychologically to get the first weight above the head successfully. All the judges, three judges, and you need two white lights and a red, or in this case, three white lights, and that's a very good start for the former European under 23 champion. Yuri Orshag's coaching team have said that he's going to move up to 183 kilograms, but I don't believe that for a second. The next lifter due to come in is the German. So the bar now moves up to 185 kilograms. On that bar is in around 29 and a half stones. First lift for Almir Vlachik, now 30 years of age. Body weight 141.41 kilograms, so he's lifting something in the region of 45 kilograms above his own body weight. The heavier the man, the less weight lifted to body weight happens. Ooh, struggled with that a bit, but he sat back on it and had a bit of a bounce, and he's made it, much to his relief. So successfully negotiated. 185 kilograms, and we may well see the Czech lifter Yuri Orshag really had to sit down in that one. Remember, over 29 stones in that bar, and he made it look reasonably easy. Orshag, a former junior world bronze medalist, just a year or so ago was the European under 23 champion, and finished with a silver medal in the senior European championships last year. So he's moved up 5 kilograms, second attempt now for Orshag from the Czech Republic. On the bar, 187 kilograms. Not a terribly wide grip. It's all about one clean, crisp movement. Hold. Oh, look at the wobble on those thighs. And he did very well. Oh, he's not too far away from his very best. Indeed, if I'm not mistaken, that is a personal best for the lifter from the Czech Republic. Long way to go, mind you, puts him into first place in the snatch. But we haven't seen some of the serious contenders come in, and won't for quite some time. He worked extremely hard, and he certainly didn't give up. A lot of lifters might just have dropped that one, but he dug in. Well, Orshak has decided to move up, and it was to be the defending Olympic champion, Steiner from Germany. But now we're going to see the first attempt by the man who won the bronze medal in the World Championships last year in Paris. Now 31 years of age. This is the second Olympic Games. Was very disappointed, didn't record a total in 2008. And remember, unlike the World Championships, where there are medals given for both the snatch and the second discipline, the clean and jerk in the Olympic weightlifting tournament, the totals are added together, so there's only one medal for the total lift made by totting up the best of the two lifts. So here's the Korean. Oh, he made that look so easy. It's all about getting the first lift right and pitching the right weight in. And sometimes if you fail, you're in trouble. And when you lift it as easily as that, then you wonder why you didn't start with something a little bit heavier. So we're moving up now to 190 kilograms on the bar. A look again at this massive Korean. Second heaviest man in the tournament, incidentally. Back again comes Almir Velacik from Germany, his first attempt at 190 kilograms. And he's lighter than his Korean opponent, so at the moment, if he gets this one, it would put him up into first place. If he doesn't get it, he's in a bit of trouble. And again, he had to sit back, and a great roar from the German supporters who are here. And three white lights, and what a good lift. 190 kilograms. A very good lift. Third lift. Big welcome to Orshak. This is the third attempt. For the representative from the Czech Republic, Jiří Orshak. Velacik and Young from Korea have both lifted 190. The Koreans, incidentally, decided he's going to go up to 198. So this is the third and last lift for the man from the Czech Republic. 182, 187 on that bar, 190 kilograms, which is going to extend his personal best, and he couldn't quite manage it, but he has posted two good lifts, so he will take a very best of 187 into the clean and jerk, and he'll now get a bit of a rest. Did that quite well, but you could see that the right-hand side was just a little bit skew-whiff, and frustration on the faces of his coaches. So close. Next up is a 27-year-old Georgian, Irakli Turmanidze, bronze medalist at this year's European Championships with a total of 423 kilograms, 12th in the World Championships last year. This is his first attempt, 192 kilograms on that bar. Looks well warmed up. Oh, clean, impressive lift. A little bit of a spiral to his right, but no problems at all. And he'll probably pop it up by another 5 kilograms, I would say. So we're going to see the first attempt of the reigning Olympic champion, Matthias Steiner of Germany. In the meantime, the man from Georgia did a very good lift. Well, what a moment for him. It was 4 years ago in Athens when he took the Olympic title, had the gold medal round his neck, and in one hand he had clutched the picture of his wife, who just the previous year had died in a car accident. So a poignant moment for him, and those pictures were seen all around the world. This is the first attempt for the reigning and defending Olympic champion, Steiner from Germany, 192 kilograms for his opening snatch. He's had his injury problems, knee problems, and one or two other problems, but he's made that very nicely. Very good lift for Steiner. So Germany's going to follow Germany. Steiner, the Olympic champion. This is third Olympic Games. Lifted for Austria in 2004 before falling out with the Austrian Federation and then spending 3 years waiting for his German citizenship. And how glad Germany was that he actually did that. And here's another German who, like Steiner, was not born in Germany. In fact, he was born in Bosnia. 30 years of age, was placed overall 8th in Beijing 4 years ago. This is final lift, 192 on the bar, and he sat down again, and he's made it again. He makes it look very difficult, but once it's up there, he makes it look very easy. Well, thank you very much indeed. 192 kilograms. So we're going to see a Russian referee coming in, a Russian lifter, I should say, coming in at 196. That was a very good lift. The Russian Albegov has decided to move up, the reigning European champion. And Vlachik has another good look at the bar, and he said, was that really me doing that? Yes, it was. Second lift for the defending champion. Knee injury kept him out of both the German Championships and the World Championships last year. Suffers also from type 1 diabetes. Here he is, though, second. First attempt at 196. Couldn't get the hands any wider. Oh gosh, oh, that's come down and he's thumped himself. Now we're hoping he's all right. I don't think it's too bad. He managed to get out of the way, and that really was a lot of problems, and they bring the screen in straight away just in case the athlete is injured. And that's just to stop people taking photographs of him on the weightlifting platform. It looked as if he was going to get it. We may get another chance to see that again. Doctors and paramedics will come straight in. We'll give him plenty of attention. I don't think he's too badly hurt. I certainly hope he's not too badly hurt. 196 kilograms on that bar. That's coming up to 31 stone. And he got it caught across the back of his neck. Well, I'm delighted to say that he's up. Well, what a roar he gets from the crowd. A roar of relief as much as adulation. Huge German contingent here. 196 kilograms, Clipton on the back of the neck. How on earth did he recover from that? Almost 31 stones around the back of the ears. Packed arena here in the XL Center to look at the man who can lift more than anybody else in the whole world above their heads. And at the moment, it's going to have to be Steiner unless they decided to move up the Germans. The tiny little scoreboard to the right of the main electronic scoreboard says that Steiner is going to move up. So we're going to see the first lift at 197 kilograms from the Ukrainian Ihor Shemesko from Ukraine, was fifth in Athens 4 years ago. Now 26 years of age, the European champion in 2011, and fifth place in the world's that same year, 2011. Former silver medalist in the Junior World Championships. So Shemechko at 197 kilograms, coming up to the 200 kilogram mark. Tall fella, couldn't make it, didn't get it above his head, didn't really sit down, didn't get the backside down close enough to the platform to make it a little bit easier for him. So that's a failure. He will have to wait for 2 minutes. Now if you fail with your opening weight or any weight and you have still more to come, you cannot drop down. You can have another attempt at the same weight, or as we've seen on a number of occasions down the years, move up an extra weight. So Igor Shemechko from the Ukraine will come in again. Body weight 137.38 kilograms. He's about 12 kilograms lighter than Steiner. If he comes in and makes this with a second attempt, then he'll go into the lead at the moment. Now 26 years of age, 5 world championships behind him. Bronze medal 3 years ago. ...197 kilograms, the second attempt for the Ukrainian Shmechko. Over 31 stones in that bar. He has to hold it. He's got to be steady. I don't know that they're going to give it to him. Has he done enough? Yes, he has. Majority decision. Well, he did wobble, and he had to hang on, and he was very, very nearly stepping off the platform, which would have made it a no lift. So 197 kilos. Into the lead he goes. Just about and no more. Oh, he wobbled, and he tottered, and he steadied, and he held, and he made it good. Big, tall fella, very wide grip, and leaned forward before he was really steady with the bar above his head, and how he had to compensate. Look at that, his toe was nearly off the lifting platform. Well, less than a minute before we'll see the man whom we thought was seriously injured, and delighted that he wasn't, the reigning Olympic champion, Matthias Steiner from Germany. Is having a second lift at 197 kilograms. Just checking that he's okay. Confirmation. Now, is he going to come out and do this? He's got 20 seconds to get himself out there. And I don't know that he's going to come out. Is he going to come out? Unless they're deciding to put him up, which they can't do. That time has elapsed. And I don't think Steiner's going to come out. I think Steiner's injured, and he's not going to come out. Well, there's a bell has gone, and that indicates that Steiner is not going to come out. So he's going to have to be content with 192 kilograms. No lift for Steiner. He didn't come out within the prescribed time. So he finishes with a best of 192 kilograms. And I don't think with some very serious men to come, he's going to be in among the medals this time. This is the world silver medalist from last year, 28-year-old from Iran, Syed Anousheravani. 198 kilograms on the bar, this to go into the lead in the opening discipline. Huge Iranian support here.
Excellent lift.
Straight in at 198 kilograms. 437 pounds. We still haven't seen the reigning world champion yet, his fellow Iranian, but that was a good opening attempt, 198 kilograms. Ruslan Albegov, the bar at 198 kilograms. He's got a lower body weight than the Iranian, so this would put him into first place in this snatch.
Good lift for the Russian.
24 years of age. The reigning European champion starts off as an Olympic challenge with a very successful lift. Very quick action, wide hands, bit of a stagger, but got it right. Swift movement, a little bounce in the midriff, which is fine. No secondary movement, right behind the heads, and got the back and the head and the neck all aligned. Terminator Georgia was from Georgia was successful with 192 kilograms. Now he's moving up to 198 kilograms. And because of his lower body weight, this would put him into first place. 126.23 kilograms he weighs. On the bar is over 70 kilograms more than his body weight. European bronze medalist has made a very good second lift. One more attempt at the snatch to go, and he looks very comfortable with that. Terminidze and Georgia have posted a third lift of 199 kilograms, but he probably will move up. And he is going up, and the bar is going to go up for the very first time to 200 kilograms. Which is the greatest weight we've seen shifted in the snatch, needless to say, throughout the tournament. This pretty hefty Korean is coming in, Jeong Sang-wen, 200 kilograms on the bar, 441 pounds, about 31 and a half stones. He's gone up by 10 kilograms from 190 to 200. So he's added about a stone and a half to that bar. It's Still got 30 seconds to make the lift good. Next to 10 kilograms, a little bit too much for him, but he can't go back. No lift, so he will have to attempt that again. Ihor Shemetsko from the Ukraine is going to come in with the same weight because it's his third lift and the third precedes second. In this case, third precedes third. Shemetsko just about the tallest of the lifters. Didn't make that one either. Failed with 197, made 197, failed with 200 kilograms, but he has recorded a good lift, and that means he will take that lift, and he's in currently in fourth place at the moment. He will take that lift into the clean and jerk a little bit later on. Second lift just wasn't there. Failed to total 4 years ago in Beijing in 2008. Bronze medalist in the 2011 World Championships. .200 kilograms remains on the bar. He had a good opening snatch of 190. Failed once with 200. Last chance in this, the first of the two disciplines. Well below his best, so no lift for the 31-year-old Korean, and he finishes with the best of 190, and at the moment that's him down in about 8th place at the moment, 7th place. Well, the man they just called Salimi Behad, Salimi Korasiabe, coming in for his opening lift, the reigning world champion, the gold medal favorite, on the bar 201 kilograms, 440 pounds, about 31 and a half stones, maybe a wee bit more. This is the man they've all come to see. Is he going to be the strongest man in the world? Ooh, he had to work really hard at that one, but he made it. The heaviest man in the competition at 168.19 kilograms body weight, but that's a good opening lift. He is the world record holder in this discipline with 214 kilograms. Quite a distance away from that at the moment, but 201 kilograms is not a bad opener in this year's first Olympic Games. Hard to believe he's only 22. Third lift for Termanidze from Georgia, currently lying in second place. And if he gets this one because of his much, much lighter body weight, he's about 40 kilograms, believe it or not, lighter than the massive Iranian, he will move into first place. Oh, he's done well. What a great, swift, disciplined lift by Termanidze. So he moves into first place because of his lighter body weight, and that's going to force the Iranian, needless to say, who's two more lifts to move up, and he has decided to move up. He's moving up to 204 kilograms. That was a terrific lift by the Georgian. bronze medalist in the European Championships this year. And he has made great strides in the last 12 months. Second lift for the second Iranian. Clear with 198. Had to struggle a little bit. He's moved up 6 kilograms to 204 for his first attempt at that weight. Well, he has another attempt at that. He's on 198, so he stays in fourth place at the moment. Didn't get it far enough back, was still well in front of his head when he was forced to let it go. Ooh, you need to lean back, and you didn't lean back. Reigning European champion from Russia, the 24-year-old Ruslan Obegov, on the bar, 204 kilograms. This is second lift. He was clear with 198. He stepped up another 6 kilograms, and he will move into first place if he makes this one good. 147.15 kilograms body weight. He's made that look comparatively easy. Moves into first place, Albegov. 204 kilograms. It's starting to warm up very nicely. So the number two lifter in the world, the second Iranian lifter, Anush Ravani, is going to have to come in and have another attempt at this weight, unless he decides to move up. Because he does have the heavier body weight, and he's heavier than the Russian, but he's decided not to bother about that. He's really got to try to nail this to stay very much in touch. Now, if he lifts this, he would move into second place because he's heavier than the Russian. Struggled a wee bit the first lift with 198. Ambitious move up to 204. Failed first time. Second time at 204 kilograms. Looks better, steady, and he's done it. So he moves up into second place because of his heavier body weight. And they've decided now to put 205 kilograms on the bar for the reigning world champion and the gold medal favorite. But this fella has moved himself up into a silver medal place at the moment. But the world's number one has got a couple of lifts to come. What a relief. Had to really work hard at it. On the bar, 205 kilograms. If the world champion and the gold medal favorite gets this one at about 452 pounds, that's just over 32 stones in this bar. Heaviest man in the competition, so he has to lift more than everybody else. Oh, and he has done. He has done. He is the world record holder in this discipline with 214 kilograms, which he set in the World Championships in Paris last year. He's going to be way short of that. But 205.15 puts him into the lead. He's in the lead and he has one more lift in the snatch just to give himself a bit more of a cushion going into the clean and jerk, which is maybe the slightly weaker of his two disciplines. 2-1-4 maximum, bit short of that, but he has one more lift to go and the world champion moves into Olympic gold medal place. Well, the man from Russia has decided to post a weight of 208 kilograms. He's less than a minute now to lift this one. He is the European champion. He's 24 years of age. Was always going to be one of the medal favorites, but this will be just a fantastic lift for him. This is his best attempt at the snatch, or his best snatch by some considerable distance in Turkey last year. Or earlier this year, I should say. He did 191, so he's way above that. Oh, that's a great lift. Just managed to get the feet together. Has he got the three lights? Yes, he has. 208 kilograms for the man from the Russian Federation who moves into first place. And that's going to force the world number one to think of going up because he's much, much lighter. He wobbled a little bit and he eventually got it. What a terrific lift by the Russian. And is there going to be a surprise on the cards here with the clean and jerk to come? Mind you, the reigning world champion has still got one more lift to go. And he's decided also to go for 208. Now, even if he makes this, because he's considerably heavier than the Russian, he won't move into first place. 201, 205, 208. 208 is some 6 kilograms under his own 214 kilogram world record set in the World Championships, as we mentioned, in Paris last year. He's in second place at the moment, and this, if he gets it, will keep him in second place. Well, he has got it. And you suddenly thought he had a wee bit more, and he says, look, that was a bit easy for me. Why didn't I go up a little bit more? But he makes 208 kilograms, and this is going to be a cracking end to what's been a wonderful weightlifting program. Huge support here from the Iranians. So at the end of the snatch, it's the Russian Albegov with 208 kilograms ahead on lower body weight from Salim, the reigning world champion, and the second Iranian, Arushavani, in third place on 204, followed by the Georgian Turmanidze. That was very, very easy, and I think it was maybe 4 or 5 or even 6 kilograms more to come. So did they get the opening lift wrong and subsequent lifts wrong? We'll have to wait and see. It's all now down to the clean and jerk to decide who's going to be the Olympic champion here in London 2012. A little bit of a bounce and he whipped that above his head, the heaviest man by some way. And because he's much heavier than his Russian opponent, he doesn't move into first place. Well, they got through that very, very quickly indeed. And there is the ranking. Or the standings after the snatch. The man with the lower body weight, Ruslan Albegov from Russia. 3 clean lifts, 198, 204, 208. And then Salim, the world champion, 201, 205, 208. But he's the heavier man, and the second Iranian, Anushiravani, with 204, followed by Turmanidze. And then Shmeko with 197. Lifter from the B group, incidentally, from Belarus, has moved up into the top half dozen. Don't think he'd contend in terms of the overall ratings, but a number of the B group lifters did particularly well. So in under 10 minutes time, we shall be back for the climax of the weightlifting tournament here in London 2012, the heaviest weight division of all. Those men above 105 kilograms, minimum weight is about 16 and a half stones, and some of them are an awful lot more than that. But it's Russia in first place, Iranian in silver medal place, and Iranian and an Iranian in bronze medal place. More in about 10 minutes.
على الميدالية الفضية والأمر يبدو أنه سيكون
Thank you.
1 minute to go, and then we'll have something in the region of between 30 and 40 minutes to decide who is the strongest man on the planet at the moment. It's been a very, very excellent competition in the first discipline, the snatch, and only 7 kilograms separates the top four lifters. It's Russia, followed by the two Iranians, followed by Georgia, and then Ukraine, Germany, Korea, the Czech Republic, and Germany. Some way short of world and Olympic records in the opening discipline, the snatch, which was won by the Russian Ruslan Albigov, lifted exactly the same as the world number one Salimi from Iran, but was much lighter, and therefore he's in first place. The Olympic record for the clean and jerk is 263 kilograms, and the world record for the clean and jerk is 263 kilograms, both set in the Athens Olympic Games by the Iranian Hossein Rezazadeh. So the first person to take part in the clean and jerk section, which is the two movement lift, is the Ukrainian Igor Shmekel, 225 kilograms on the bar. Good split, and he steadies it up, and that's a good lift in his first attempt. So the clean and jerk is underway. That gives him a total of 422 kilograms. So after that one lift, he moves into first place. Also on the bar, 225 kilograms, Irakli Terminidze from Georgia. This will put him into first place because of his lighter body weight. Best in the snatch of 201 kilograms. Struggled a wee bit with that one. He's very quick. Good technician, needs to hold it. Now, has he got the three white lights? Yes, he has. Good lift for Terminadze. Terminadze has posted a second attempt of 226, but I think he will probably move up. So 229 kilograms on the bar. His best snatch was 192, and this would put him into the lead. Born in Bosnia 30 years ago, 8th in this weight division in Beijing in 2008. Always makes it look difficult up until the point where he gets the three white lights. Splendid opening attempt. It's well over 500 pounds in that bar. Got himself up reasonably quickly. Very little in the way of readjustment and a good push, and he got the feet right. Good straight clean lift. The bar now 231 kilos. Remember, the Olympic and world record stand at 263, so we're some way below that. This is the first lift in the clean and jerk. for the man from the Czech Republic. 231 kilograms on the bar. He's about 40 seconds. Jiří Oršák finished with the best in the snatch. Failed at 190, but had cleared first 182 and then 187. Good opening left. Well, a long way to go, but that puts him into first place. 187 plus his 231 gives him a total of 418. The Olympic record and world record total is 472. Out for his second lift, his first attempt at 232 kilograms is Ihor Shumenko from the Ukraine, currently in fourth place. And this would move him up into the gold medal position, but a lot of lifting to be done. Well, we got there. Just about at the very extent of his limit and his strength. Terminator from Georgia is going to come up to try to lift the same weight, because his body weight is less. He will move into first place. And as we're looking again at Shmetsko, doing it all again. They've given the bar a bit of a clean. Sometimes you get little blisters. There's a little bit of blood on the bar, and they've had to give it a good wipe. So here is the Georgian, Irakli Terminidze. 12th at last year's World Championships, but he's made good progress. 232 kilograms on the bar to take him into first place. First bad lift he's had, so he'll have to attempt that again, or maybe decide to go up. This looks out as if to say, you naughty weight. And because the Ukrainian has finished, it's going to be the third attempt for this fellow, and the second attempt at 232. Just let it go a little bit too far behind his head. The first part of the two-part lift, the clean and jerk, was well executed. Now, are they thinking of going up from 232 kilograms? He's entitled to do that. Because he failed at 232 kilograms, doesn't mean that he has to stay at it. He can't, of course, go down. He can lift exactly the same weight, or he can move up a little bit to put the pressure on the men coming behind him. He's the lightest of all the lifters at 126.23 kilograms. And if he gets this, he would move into first place. Was in fourth place in the snatch with a lift of 201 kilograms. Still got just under a minute of the 2 minutes that's allowed to him. If the same lifter is returning, then you've got 2 minutes, otherwise it's a minute between lifters. So for the very last time in the weightlifting tournament in London 2012, this is the man from Georgia, 27 years of age, Irakli Terminidze, 12th in last year's World Championships. The best of 398, this to better that by some distance. Now, he got the first part right, as he did the last time. This was the bit that was difficult, and he needs to bring that leg forward, and he's done it as he got the white lights.
all three of them. Well, the crowd really got behind him, and a nice little smile on his face. And the Rackley Terminage moves up into first place with a total of 433 kilograms, and that's by some distance a personal best. The lightest of all the lifters, and he has shifted 234 kilograms above his head. 36 stones. What a lift. Bosnian born lifting for Germany, Almir Velacic on the bar, 234 pounds. Ooh, we just about made that. And again he's got there. Oh, he can't believe it. He's delighted with that. That gives him a total of 426 kilograms. Such a lot of effort just to get himself up into the vertical position. Minimal adjustment, a little bit of a wobble on the left-hand side, but he kept it steady enough to get the three white lights. The Ukrainian Ihor Shemechko is coming out to attempt 235 kilograms to move him into second place. First place at the moment is Velagic, and Shemechko has decided to move up. It's all getting very interesting now, because everybody's decided that they're very confident with the clean and jerk, which is maybe just slightly less technical and a better example of strength than the snatch. So for the first time in the clean and jerk, we are going to see the number two Iranian, the world silver medalist from last year, Sajjad Anousheravani. ...439 kilograms was his total in the World Championships in Paris last year. First attempt at 237, this to put him into the lead. He had a best snatch of 204, this to give him 441. Made that look reasonably easy. Very wide split. He's got to get the feet together and hold it, and he's done it. Great lift, and that takes him into gold medal position with a total of 441. Now it's going to be Shemechko from the Ukraine. Good opening piece of straightening, and then he got that bar well above his head. Shemechko currently in third place with 429. This to increase his total. The tallest of all the lifters. Couldn't quite make that, so thank you very much indeed. The Ukrainian boys out, but his total of 429 kilograms moves him into third place. So currently he's sitting in bronze medal position, but that will change pretty quickly. Just didn't really get that. You can see by the readjustment he wasn't comfortable at that point. Left leg maybe just too far back. He didn't really get underneath it. Almir Belagic, representing Germany. And just to remind you, if you're just joining us, that the defending Olympic champion, Matthias Steiner from Germany, withdrew. He had what looked like a, well, I don't think it was a serious accident, but it could have been a serious accident when he dropped something in the region of 197 kilograms in the back of his neck. Well, that's not going to happen, is it, for his fellow countrymen. Steiner born in Austria, Belagic born in Bosnia. So he bows out with a total of 426 kilograms. Means that he's finished at the moment in fourth place, and we're now starting to get to the business end of this competition. Oshak just simply couldn't make it. 23 years of age, European silver medalist. So here's the man from the Czech Republic, Jiří Oshak. First lift was good at 231 kilograms, giving him a total of 418. This one is not going to be good enough, I don't think, to take among the medals, if my sums are right. Well done. Hold it, and he does. What do the judges think? All three give him three white lights. Great lift for Oshag, moves him up into fourth place. That was a very, very good lift by Oshag. Very confident. Just steadied himself in time. Well, this is the man who led because of his lighter body weight, posted the same lift in the snatch as the reigning world champion from Iran, but much, much lighter. Iranian, of course, is expected to lift an awful lot more than this. 240 kilograms on the bar. First attempt from the Russian. Started this discipline in the gold medal place. Needs this to move back into gold medal place. A little bit of a stutter, but he got there. Good opening lift by Ruslan Albegov. Total now of 448 kilograms, so he's got a 7-point lead over his nearest challenger. But we haven't seen either the Korean or the number one Iranian. Jung Sang-hwan from Korea coming in as we look again at Albegov's excellent opening lift in the clean and jerk. Well, the Korean has decided to move up to 242, but Albegov has decided to move up. ...242 kilograms on the bar for Jiří Oshag from the Czech Republic. Oshag second lightest in this tournament, on this weight division, 128.15 kilograms on the bar, 242 kilograms. Successful at 231 and again at 239. Just to move into fourth place on lighter body weight. No, he never looked like it. Sorry about that. So Oshag finishes with the best lift of 239. He stays on 426 for his total. And around me, you simply can't move for Iranian fans and Iranian supporters moving around who want to get as close to the lifting platform as they possibly can. I don't know where they're all going to sit. I'm assuming they have tickets. As we look again at the last attempt of Oshag from the Czech Republic. 231, 239, failed at 242, total of 426. And just waiting in the wings as they check the weights. 245 kilograms, so it's moved up by 3 kilograms. There is the world champion, just waiting to see if he can become the Olympic champion. Here is the world silver medalist to see if he can push his compatriot all the way. This to move into first place. 245 kilograms on the bar. He's gone up by 8 kilograms. This will take him on to, I think, 449 of a total, and we'll move him into first place. So are we still looking at an Iranian 1-2 here in London 2012? This is the number two Iranian, the world silver medalist, to move into gold medal place. Wide split, needs to hold it. He has held it, the Iranian flags wave. And he's delighted with that. And Ashurabani moves into first place with a total of 449 kilograms. He leads the competition. 204 in the snatch, now 237. 245, I should say, in the clean and jerk. Well, he wobbled a little bit, and the important thing was he got that right leg up to match the left, and he held it long enough to get the three white lights. Now attempting the same weight is Ruslan Albegov from Russia, the man who led the snatch with the lower body weight. Same lift as the Iranian, but if he gets it, he will move into first place. 30 seconds to go. He's allowed a minute. His technique has been quite terrific. Ooh, confident stuff. Didn't quite make it, but he still has one more attempt at 245, or indeed he may decide to go up. So he remains in second place with one lift to come. And Arushivani says that he's going up, so he's going to force the Russian to take his third and last attempt, and I'm pretty sure he will stay at 245. Just couldn't get those arms locked out. Everything else seemed to be fine. He's lifted very well all the way through, and we're going to see the Russian again. This is now getting down to the business end, and remember, we haven't seen either the world number one or the lifter from Korea. He was the world bronze medalist last year lifting.
Well, there was a weight posted for the first attempt of 246, and Albegov has decided to move up. So this is the man who was third in the World Championships last year, the Korean, the second heaviest man at 157.53 kilograms body weight, and on that bar 246 kilograms. Well, that is a surprise. Albegov has decided to move up the Russian to 251 kilograms. If he gets this, then if he gets that, then he will move into gold medal position, but we still have not seen Salimi, the world champion. 2 minutes now will elapse and allow the Korean just to compose himself for his second attempt at 246 kilograms. Well below his best in the snatch, incidentally, with two failures at 200 kilograms. Got his first attempt at 190. And even if he gets this at 246, he'll be still just about in bronze medal position, if my sums are right. So this to put the enormous Korean into the bronze medal position. Needs this for a medal. He's struggling again. Can he do it? He's got to stay steady. Hold it. Down it goes. What do they say? They like it. Well, he really had to work hard at that. My word, that cost him. And he's moved into bronze medal position. And we're going to see the reigning world champion come in for his very first attempt as we look again at one of his rivals who with this lift has put himself into the bronze medal position. Still has one lift to come. Had to stagger and totter and teeter a little bit, but he got there. Well, here's the man they've all come to see. Not at his best in the snatch. He was the world record holder, is the world record holder in the snatch. The 214 was 6 kilograms below that at his best, and because his nearest rival, Ruslan Albegov from Russia, was a much lighter body weight, the Russian went into first place. But this is to go into gold medal position. And he's two more in the bank. Belt just coming adrift there, but he not noticed that. Now concentrate. He does. Fantastic lift. 247 kilograms. He moves up into first place with a total of 455. The Olympic record, the world record is 472, held by his fellow Iranian set in the Sydney Olympic Games some 12 years ago. But at the moment, he is the man who, well, as was tipped, is in position to take the gold medal.
Oh, he's got that up. And that's certainly pretty close to a gold medal lift. Now, exactly the same weight is being attempted by Ruslan Albegov. He is, in terms of body weight, some 20 kilograms lighter than the massive Iranian. Same weight, this will put him on gold medal position. But he needs this. Missed with 245. Can he get 247 to put pressure on the Iranian? Lighter body weight, crucial. First part good. Second part good. Can he hold it? Don't think he's going to get that. Couldn't quite lock it out. Very close. Got three red lights. And that means that no matter what happens, Iran have the Olympic gold medalist. And as it turns out, the silver medalist as well. No matter what happens, it's going to be Iran 1 and 2. But who's going to occupy those positions? Very, very close from Albegov. And he very, very nearly made it. He wasn't steady, he wasn't straight. And all three judges said that that was a no lift. Three red lights. He needed at least two white and a red, or preferably all three whites. And they thought he'd got it. Oh, how disappointing. Well, this is the man who's in the lead, the world champion. Maybe a few minutes away from becoming the Olympic champion, but his buddy, his teammate, his fellow Iranian has other things to say about this. World silver medalist last year. Finished with a total of 439 kilograms. He's exceeded that here in London 2012. And if he gets this because of his lighter body weight, he's going to move into the gold medal position. Oh, not even close. Not even close. So he's settled for silver. He's settled for silver. Didn't do it. So one more lift from the Korean. Currently in fourth place with 436, with a lift still to go. But if he gets this, he will move into the bronze medal position, just squeezing out the Russian Ruslan Albegov. Bronze medalist at the World Championships last year with a total of 433. Kilograms on that bar. Well, they've asked him to stop. I'm not quite sure why. I'm maybe just going to adjust the bar. Maybe the weight's not quite right. Well, they didn't have the weight right. They forgot to move the weight up. It was 251, and they hadn't moved it up to 259. Even though that was the weight that had been posted by the Koreans, so they just got it in time.
Ukraine, Jean Sangwin, lifts this. It's the bronze medal.
Couldn't make it. So he buzzed out with the best lift in the clean and jerk of 246. Finishes with a total of 436. And that keeps him down in fourth place. And the world champion has decided to go up to 264 kilograms for a new Olympic record in the clean and jerk and a new world record in the clean and jerk. He has decided amazingly to move up by 17 kilograms. 247 his first negotiated, and he's moved up to 264. And these records held by his fellow Iranian, Hussein Rezazadeh, set in Athens 8 years ago in 2004. 263 has stood as the Olympic record since then and has stood as the world record since then. This is serious ambition. He is in first place. So this is just a matter of seeing if he can break every single record. Didn't even get close. Didn't get close. Is he going to have another go? He may not. He's got 2 minutes. He's got two more minutes if he wants. And I don't think he's going to bother. He doesn't need to. Highly ambitious. Yeah, a little bit too much even for me. So the world champion becomes the Olympic champion. It is, as expected, Iran gold and silver, and Russia in bronze, Korea in fourth place. He's not going to bother. And it's delight for the two Iranian lifters and their small army of fans here. And once again, they have shown what a major force in the heavyweight divisions they are. Look at the size of those two men. The two heaviest men in the competition have proved themselves the two strongest men in the competition. Salimi, nearly 170 kilos. His buddy just over 150 kilos. They are the two strongest men in the world. No records in this division. The records will stand. He had an attempt at it just to please the crowd, and even though he had one more lift to go, he decided not to bother. The 22-year-old, I don't think is going to come out and do it again. He still has another minute, but I don't think he's going to do it. Well, maybe he will. He seems happy. He seems happy. Unless he's going to break the world record, there's not a lot of point in coming out and having a third lift. Very happy Iranian coach. Yeah, numbers one and numbers two. Congratulations to the Russian coach who saw his man go into bronze medal position. So it's Iran one and two, and Russia in bronze medal position just ahead of the Korean. Now the clock is ticking away, and Salimi has decided there's absolutely no point in having another go at that world record, because an increase of 17 kilograms was even beyond him. A wee bit of fantasy there, but he'll be very happy. A year ago in Paris he became the world champion, and here in London in 2012 he's become the Olympic champion. So definitely confirmed as no lift. And now we have to wait for the medal ceremony. And once again, it's gold for Iran, silver for Iran, and bronze for Russia. Great competition. So here they come, the medalists in the weightlifting plus 105 kilogram category. 1-2 for the Islamic Republic of Iran. And third place, Russia. No records broken, but one record attempted, or two records attempted, in the very last lift of the man who's going to be crowned the Olympic champion. I'm pretty sure we'll see a lot more of this fella. He's only 24 years of age, the reigning European champion, and he increased his total from the European champions by 19 kilograms, finished in bronze medal place, led after the snatch with a great lift of 208, and had he landed 247 kilograms in his last attempt in the clean and jerk because of his lower body weight, he might well have been getting the gold medal instead of the bronze, which he certainly deserves. Sajjad Arushavani, like the Russian, because of his lighter body weight, had one serious attempt at putting pressure on his teammate, but failed, posted a total of 449 kilograms, but good enough by one single kilogram to give him the Olympic silver medal. The world silver medalist becomes the Olympic silver medalist. Known simply as Salimi, pats the gold medal podium. He was the world champion and is now the Olympic champion. Had a serious go at breaking the total in the world record for clean and jerk, but failed, but nevertheless, despite that, and he is actually still quite a youngster. He's only 22 years of age. World record holder in the snatch, world champion, and now Salimi, as he's known, the length and breadth of Iran, is the Olympic champion.
Well, that concludes the weightlifting tournament here in London 2012. Records have tumbled, perhaps not in the 105 plus kilogram division, but as expected, it was Iran 1 and 2, Salimi, Anusha Devani, and in bronze medal position, the man from Russia, Ruslan Albigov. I hope you've enjoyed our coverage of the weightlifting tournament. And until Beijing 2016, it's goodbye from me, Jim Neely.